If you take glycerin, which is a very common food additive, it's non-toxic, and you react it with a mixture of nitric and sulfuric acids, you'll make nitroglycerin. Nitroglycerin in its liquid form is very unstable, very reactive, shock sensitive. The Italian chemist Ascanio Sobrero was credited for discovering it in 1847. And from what I've read, when he first created it, he was experimenting with its properties. He took a small amount of it, put it into a test tube, and heated it. And when he did that, it decomposed rapidly, in other words, exploded, and it threw glass shards everywhere, and apparently it cut up his face pretty badly. As I mentioned, nitroglycerin is really dangerous. Making it is dangerous. Shipping it is dangerous. Storing it is dangerous. You have to follow procedures. And if you don't follow the stated procedures, you can have trouble. So there were factories blowing up. There were some ships that blew up. You had a problem in one or two ports. If you look at this man, he's sitting on a one-legged stool. And that illustrates the one of the problems, and that is staying awake to watch the reaction mixture. I guess it takes a while. And he's watching for a temperature spike, because if the temperature does spike, he'll pull a lever, which will cause the hot reaction mixture to fall into a vat of ice water, which will quench it. If he starts to nod off, well, it's hard to nod off on a one-legged stool, because you'll fall off, wake him up. Where Nobel, Alfred Nobel, made his money was in dynamite. So he discovered a way to make nitroglycerin relatively safe. You take the nitroglycerin, dissolve it in a clay-like material, or diatomaceous earth, that's the A, and you form it in a tube. And then the B is a protective layer around it. C is a blasting cap, because now when it's in this form, it's relatively safe. And if you want to detonate it, you've got to initiate it. So the blasting cap is the initiator. And then D is a wire to allow you to remote detonate it. So Nobel made a crazy amount of money in nitroglycerin, dynamite, and blasting caps. That's where the money for the Nobel Prizes has come from over the years. Now we're going to calculate the enthalpy of reaction for the decomposition of nitroglycerin according to this chemical equation. I'm going to go a little faster through this than I did for the previous one, which was the production of hydrogen gas from steam and methane. So you need to know how to write your standard enthalpy of formation equations, how to do the manipulations, because I'm not going to explain them in the same detail. So which ones will I have to write equations for? Nitroglycerin, carbon dioxide, and water. I will not write equations for the formation of nitrogen and oxygen gases because those are in their elemental form. I'll go left to right just because I like to go left to right. So let's write an enthalpy of formation equation for nitroglycerin. So the reactants are elements in their natural state, and then you've got nitroglycerin on the right-hand side. You've got fractional coefficients because it can only be for one nitroglycerin, and the reactants have to be elemental state. You look up the standard enthalpy of formation. So now we've got that one. Next, I have to write an equation for carbon dioxide gas. So there's the equation for the formation of carbon dioxide gas from its elements. And there's the standard enthalpy of formation. Now we worry about gaseous water. And there's the chemical equation for the formation of gaseous water from its elements. And then you get the table value. A reminder, those standard enthalpies of formation are per mole. That's why each of those is written for one mole. But any that need to be adjusted will take care of that. I'll start with the nitroglycerin, which means I'll take the first thermochemical equation. Two things that are problems. One, I need nitroglycerin as a reactant. Two, I need 4 moles of nitroglycerin. So I reverse the reaction and I multiply all the coefficients by 4. Then I take the standard enthalpy of formation, I change the sign because I reversed the reaction, and now I multiply it by 4 because I took 4 moles. Next, we'll do carbon dioxide, which is the second equation. We need carbon dioxide gas as a product, and it's a product, so that's good in that bottom equation. But we need 12, so we multiply all the coefficients by 12, take the standard enthalpy of formation, do not change the sign because we did not reverse the reaction, multiply by 12, and we have one equation left, which is good because we need water vapor, so we need that bottom equation. Now in the desired equation, water vapor is a product. That's good. It's a product already. No need to reverse the reaction. But we do need 10 moles of water vapor. So all the coefficients are multiplied by 10. And then we take the standard enthalpy of formation and we multiply it by 10. So let's sum everything up as to what we've done so far. It's kind of busy, I know, but these equations in the middle, those are the modified equations. Before we can even touch the enthalpy values, we have to make sure that the chemical equations add up to the desired chemical equation. Well, I have 12 carbon solid reactant, 12 carbon solid product. Remove that. 10 H2 gas reactant, 10 H2 gas product. Remove that. A total of 17 O2 reactant and 18 O2 product. So subtract 17 from both sides, I have one O2 left. What do I have that remains? 4 moles of nitroglycerin reactant. 6 moles N2 gas product. 1 mole O2 gas product. 12 moles CO2 gas product. And 10 moles H2O gas product. So let's check. Okay, the chemical equations add up to the same as the desired equation. A couple of substances in the products are rearranged, but that's not a problem. All the reactants and all the products are there. Now, that means I can add up the standard enthalpies of reaction, and that negative 5660.0 kilojoules, that is the standard enthalpy of reaction for the decomposition of nitroglycerin.